Hi there. In this video, we will listen to the very first story in the series called Language Learners Club. It is a series of short stories about the adventures of a group of foreign exchange students in America. These lessons are designed to help you improve your English listening, reading, and speaking skills, as well as grow your vocabulary by learning useful words and phrases in context. You will hear the story three times. First, without subtitles and without translation. Your goal is to listen carefully, try to recognize familiar words, and understand the general idea of the story. Then you will hear the story again with English subtitles. You can listen to the speaker or read along. It's up to you. Lastly, you will hear the story again with English subtitles and translation. Turn on subtitles for the language of your choice to see the translation. This is the recommended order, but feel free to skip to any section you prefer. Before we start, please don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel so you won't miss any future stories. The competition. We were at the Moscow airport, saying our goodbyes. My mom was wiping away her tears. I was doing my best to hold it together, smiling and trying to comfort her. "Everything will be okay," I said. This was the first time I would be away from my family for such a long time. I was going to America. It was my first time flying abroad. Of course, I was nervous, but I didn't want to let on, especially not to my mom. I had won a language competition. As a prize, I was going to the USA as an exchange student for 1 year. I would stay with an American family and go to an American high school. It all felt a bit like a dream at that time. You see, I started learning English in grade 5. But I didn't get very far. We had to read stories about the government and history of our country. It was not very interesting, to say the least. Around the same time, my mom, who was an English teacher, started working at a private language school. She arranged for me to join language classes a couple of times a week. We had teachers from the UK and America. We watched cartoons and movies and read adventure books like Indiana Jones. We discussed things that interested us. It was great. This went on for several years. My English improved a lot. And then I quit. Looking back, I don't remember why I quit. Maybe I was just a rebellious teenager. Maybe I got bored. Maybe both. I don't remember. One day, my mom told me about this language competition. She didn't have much hope for me, since I hadn't studied English for the last couple of years. But she still thought I should give it a shot. So I did. I signed up, took some reading and writing tests, and had some interviews. That was it. They wouldn't tell us the results right away. so I forgot all about the competition. About 6 months later, we got a phone call. Congratulations. You've won the competition. You're going to America, said the friendly voice on the other end of the line. And so, there we were at the airport, saying our goodbyes. I'm so proud of you, said my mom. Please write to us and call us often. We'd love to know how you're doing. Of course, Mom, I said. It was time to go. I had the ticket in my hand, and I had already checked in my luggage. But I still had to go through customs and find my terminal. I love you, said my mom as she gave me one last hug. Love you too, I said. Excited and a bit scared, I got into the customs line. Now let's listen to the story with English subtitles. The competition. We were at the Moscow airport, saying our goodbyes. My mom was wiping away her tears. I was doing my best to hold it together, smiling and trying to comfort her. Everything will be okay, I said. This was the first time I would be away from my family for such a long time. I was going to America. It was my first time flying abroad. Of course, I was nervous, but I didn't want to let on, especially not to my mom. I had won a language competition. As a prize, I was going to the USA as an exchange student for 1 year. I would stay with an American family and go to an American high school. It all felt a bit like a dream at that time. You see, I started learning English in grade 5. But I didn't get very far. We had to read stories about the government and history of our country. It was not very interesting, to say the least. Around the same time, my mom, who was an English teacher, started working at a private language school. She arranged for me to join language classes a couple of times a week. We had teachers from the UK and America. We watched cartoons and movies and read adventure books like Indiana Jones. We discussed things that interested us. It was great. This went on for several years. My English improved a lot. And then I quit. Looking back, I don't remember why I quit. Maybe I was just a rebellious teenager. Maybe I got bored. Maybe both. I don't remember. One day, my mom told me about this language competition. She didn't have much hope for me, since I hadn't studied English for the last couple of years. But she still thought I should give it a shot. So I did. I signed up, took some reading and writing tests, and had some interviews. That was it. They wouldn't tell us the results right away. so I forgot all about the competition. About 6 months later, we got a phone call. Congratulations. You've won the competition. You're going to America, said the friendly voice on the other end of the line. And so, there we were at the airport, saying our goodbyes. I'm so proud of you, said my mom. Please write to us and call us often. We'd love to know how you're doing. Of course, Mom, I said. It was time to go. I had the ticket in my hand, and I had already checked in my luggage. But I still had to go through customs and find my terminal. I love you, said my mom as she gave me one last hug. Love you too, I said. Excited and a bit scared, I got into the customs line. Now let's listen to the story one more time, this time with English subtitles and translation. The competition. We were at the Moscow airport, saying our goodbyes. My mom was wiping away her tears. I was doing my best to hold it together, smiling and trying to comfort her. Everything will be okay, I said. This was the first time I would be away from my family for such a long time. I was going to America. It was my first time flying abroad. Of course, I was nervous, but I didn't want to let on, especially not to my mom. I had won a language competition. As a prize, I was going to the USA as an exchange student for 1 year. I would stay with an American family and go to an American high school. It all felt a bit like a dream at that time. You see, I started learning English in grade 5. But I didn't get very far. We had to read stories about the government and history of our country. It was not very interesting, to say the least. Around the same time, my mom, who was an English teacher, started working at a private language school. She arranged for me to join language classes a couple of times a week. We had teachers from the UK and America. We watched cartoons and movies and read adventure books like Indiana Jones. We discussed things that interested us. It was great. This went on for several years. My English improved a lot. And then I quit. Looking back, I don't remember why I quit. Maybe I was just a rebellious teenager. Maybe I got bored. Maybe both. I don't remember. One day, my mom told me about this language competition. She didn't have much hope for me, since I hadn't studied English for the last couple of years. But she still thought I should give it a shot. So I did. I signed up, took some reading and writing tests, and had some interviews. That was it. They wouldn't tell us the results right away. So I forgot all about the competition. About 6 months later, we got a phone call. Congratulations. You've won the competition. You're going to America, said the friendly voice on the other end of the line. And so, there we were at the airport, saying our goodbyes. I'm so proud of you, said my mom. Please write to us and call us often. We'd love to know how you're doing. Of course, Mom, I said. It was time to go. I had the ticket in my hand, and I had already checked in my luggage. But I still had to go through customs and find my terminal. I love you, said my mom as she gave me one last hug. Love you too, I said. Excited and a bit scared, I got into the customs line. Did you enjoy the story? Did you learn any new words? Please let us know in the comments. Don't forget to review this and other lessons regularly for maximum benefit. And make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any upcoming stories. Thanks for watching. See you soon at the Language Learners Club.